What's up, guys? Ryan back here for another roast video today, and I'd like to tell you that you guys roasted me better than last time, but it wasn't that much better. So last time I think we had like 300 comments on this post that I said I'm giving you guys a second chance to roast my car since you did so bad last time. We got almost 600 comments, so it's going to take me a little bit to get through all these. And hopefully out of 600, there's at least one good one out of here. But I don't know, I've skimmed through a couple of them and it's not looking too good so far. I'd say out of the 600 comments that I got on there, 98% of them were comments saying that one, my car looks like cum or something related to semen because my car's white. Two, obviously calling it a Tiburon. And three, people just flat out saying it's gay. So that's what 98% of the comments are on this post, but I'm gonna read them anyways, I guess. First, okay, so here's what I'm talking about. First comment is literally just gay. Second comment, gayer than AIDS. So I'm just gonna scroll through here until I find something decent and then I'll read it because most of these are just, you know. Oh wait, here's a cum comment that I was talking about. Now it looks like a bucket of cum, you long neck beetlehead fuck. I don't even know what the fuck a long neck beetlehead fuck is, but apparently that's me. Why are the tents so dark? You afraid of being seen in a girl's car? For the last year and a half, I've had to listen to tint your goddamn windows in the comments of every video I've posted, and now you guys want to talk shit about it. Your car went from blackened tuna to white cod. It still stinks like fucking pussy. If your car were in school, it'd be the one who eats alone at lunch and gets picked on by the cool cars. Hey, check out my new dip job. It's called cum all over my face because I can't get any bitches. How you gonna say I can't get any bitches but my car smells like pussy? That don't make no, that ain't adding up, man. Sweet Genesis, check. Turbo, check. Classy amount of wheel gap, check. Purring exhaust, he put check, but it, really my exhaust sounds like dog shit, honestly. I don't like it, but check. Real life accomplishments. What did the Genesis owner say to the WRX owner after he beat him in a race? Nothing. He turned off his Xbox and went to bed. Fuck. Well, you know what's funny is I actually raced an SDI a couple weeks ago, and Jake recorded it on his phone. And unfortunately, since Jake's a dumbass, he deleted it off his phone for whatever reason. But yeah, I put bus links on that bitch. Okay, I've been reading this same comment for like 5 minutes now and I still can't comprehend what the fuck he's trying to say. So I'm gonna read it and hopefully somebody can make sense of it. Here we go. I'm not sure if this is English or not, to be honest. When you want to be cheap, but you ain't cheap, you got cheap, bro, you're cheap. You finna going to get something to put on them tires or rims or something, but you got to finna going to put something on them cheap plasti dip, bro, you better get some speakers before you get car charger remote control. I feel like that wasn't even a legit comment. I feel like he just started pressing the middle button on his autocorrect keyboard and whatever popped up is what he typed in there. Cause that don't make no fucking sense. Fuck your gay ass car, you cunt. Your car is so white that when you come, you can't tell where you come to clean it. No matter how much you soup that thing up, it will never be fast enough to drive away from your sad life.
If it's me looking down on me, the world above my...
This man took the Gay Pride Month a little too serious. Is it actually Gay Pride Month? Because if it is, that would be fucking hilarious. Look, you want us to roast your car to laugh at, but the real laugh is when you wake up in the morning to this thing sitting and you smile and say you love it when really deep down you have some much bottled disappointment built over the months of ownership defending this Korean plastic box and building it into a cool car. You followed all the steps, put in all the work, but it didn't work out. It didn't become cool, popular, or even something that turns people's heads on the road. The real laugh is for us watching you dump money into this piece and watching you fail as the internet star trying to make it into something it's not. That's kind of depressing. Ask any racer, any real racer. It doesn't matter if your Hyundai is black or white. A Hyundai is still a fucking Hyundai. I like that one. That was actually pretty good. I see what you did there with that Fast and Furious reference, and I like it. fucking hun gay. Should be called the genocide because it systematically kill your social life and chances of getting pussy. Did you paint it white because you were tired of it not having rights? It looks whiter than the jizz you wipe off your chin. You could have had an Evo, but you chose this cock-sucking, ball-fondling, whiter-than-sour-cream piece of flaming dog shit. It's Korean, so it'll fall apart before you get that piece of rice to 350 miles per hour. Bet you haven't even put on a short-throw dipstick. That was pretty good. I'm quite impressed with that one. That was pretty good. My favorite part in that was, you chose this cock-sucking, ball-fondling, whiter-than-sour-cream piece of flaming dog shit. That's a good line. I like that. Like the typical Tiburon owner, you plasti-dipped your car instead of painting it like a civilized human being because you spend all your money on vape juice, white tees, and DC hats. It's just expensive, man. It adds up. I don't have too many white shirts, though. I do have black ones, and I have a lot of vape juice and flat bill hats, though. It's expensive. Stretch tires like your asshole. The tires really aren't that stretched, though. Hold on, wait. That sounds like I'm saying my asshole is stretched. No, neither one is stretched, really. My asshole or my tires. There's just one random comment in here that says Bobby has a fat dick. Okay. It looks like your boyfriend cummed on your gay ass car. How original, another cum comment. Fuck yeah. What the fuck? This one's funny, but Ryan's car is as wide as his dick. How? They both never see daylight because they're both always stuck up Carson's ass. For the record, my dick has never been in Carson's ass. Carson has a job and a girlfriend now, which is surprising because I didn't know he was into girls, but yeah, I don't really see him that much anymore. I will say that was a funny comment though, even though it's not true. I wouldn't cheat on Jake like that. You probably think Plasti-Dip is a mod and ask people to follow your build on Instagram. You are following my build on Instagram though. By the way, if you don't follow me on Instagram, I got a white dip Genesis coupe, so follow my build on Instagram, bro. RSpec Ryan, hit me up. And this, folks, is where sucking dick and packing fudge will get you in life. Hey, that's pretty gay. If you stick the dildo in the lipstick holder, the car drives itself to the junkyard. Your car is starting to look like a 13-year-old girl's phone. It's funny because I know exactly what he's talking about. You ever see the people with like fucking rhinestones and shit all over their phone case? It's so stupid. My mom actually has one of those, I think. Mom, it's so tacky. Street Speed 717 has two Silverados. Guitarmageddon ZL1 has two Camaros and you have one Tiburon. I should have never said that calling my car a Tiburon pisses me off because now literally everybody fucking does that. And not just people on YouTube, people in person will come up and call my car a Tiburon. I should have never fucking said it, you know what? And the people that say it in person, you know who you are. Fuck you, Carl. I bet my off-brand ass push mower can beat your gay ass faggot ass Tiburon. If you take your goddamn pinky winky skirt off, it will reduce weight, bitch. I got $5 that says my car will drag your lawnmower's ass. So line them up. You want to race for pinks, dude? I'll throw $5 and pinks on it. Let's go. Your car sounds like somebody shoved a turbo up a hippo's asshole and fed it Taco Bell. That's actually a very good explanation of how my car sounds. It literally sounds like somebody shoved a turbo up a hippo's ass and fed it Taco Bell. Because it literally sounds like shit right now. And I need to get that fixed. When you hear a turbo spool in the night sky like a screech of bald eagles, letting you know ISIS has been eliminated and Jesus has risen, but you find Ellen DeGeneres' ugly twin sister driving the eBay version of a Supra with enough wheel horsepower to barely twist my titties. I'm not sure how to respond to that, but I like it. I'd rather look at a pic of you spreading your butt cheeks wide open with your hands than look at your gay-ass car. You don't want to look at my gay-ass car, but you want to look at my fucking butt cheeks spread wide open? That's gay, bro. Okay, well, I've scrolled through all 600 of those comments, and those were the only ones worth mentioning. So, but yeah, that's all the comments I got for today. There probably won't be another video because it'll probably just be another video of me reading cum, Tiburon, and Hyundai jokes, you know, like usual. So yeah, if you guys did like the video, leave a like on it. And let me know if you guys want me to do hate comments. Now that doesn't mean that you're going to go to my fucking channel and type a hate comment and getting hate comments, but I do have some hate comments that I already have saved up on my computer. So let me know if you guys want to see that by liking this video, and I'll see you guys later. Peace. Hold up.